This problem involves uncompetitive inhibition of an enzyme-catalyzed reaction and looking at the effects of an inhibitor on the performance of a PFR compared to a CSTR. So a PFR has half the space-time required to achieve the same conversion as a CSTR in the absence of an inhibitor. And we want to find out if that ratio of 1 to 2 is any different when we have an inhibitor present. Okay, so uncompetitive inhibition is the case where we have an enzyme-substrate complex which is binding an inhibitor reversibly to produce an inhibited complex that can't react to produce more product. Okay, and remember, this occurs within the context of a Michaelis-Menten mechanism where we have E combining with a substrate, or enzyme combining with a substrate, to produce an enzyme-substrate complex, which can fall back to the unreacted enzyme and substrate, or produce a product. And so when we have inhibitor that's binding to the enzyme-substrate complex, right, it will tend to affect this species as an intermediate. All right, and so typically what we observe when we have the rate of reaction as a function of substrate concentration, all right, is that at low substrate concentration for Michaelis-Menten kinetics, then we get a linear rise, and then as we saturate the enzyme, then we level off to a constant rate at very high substrate concentration. The reason that we are leveling off is that as the substrate concentration increases, is that we've saturated all of our enzymes, so we have a lot of enzyme-substrate complex. And so we expect that the location where we have a lot of enzyme-substrate complex is the place where uncompetitive inhibition will have the greatest effect. All right, so it's going to have the largest effect out here at high enzyme-substrate complex concentration, which is where we have high substrate concentration. And so if we sketch this qualitatively on our plot, then we expect that the inhibitor is going to have the greatest effect on the rate at high substrate concentration. We can also see this from the rate expression for an uncompetitively inhibited reaction. Okay, here we have the form of that expression, right, where we see that as the inhibitor concentration goes up, the magnitude of the denominator goes up, and so our rate goes down. All right, but that effect depends on whether we're in a high substrate concentration or low substrate concentration. So in the limit of high substrate concentration, then this term becomes much greater than Km, and the inhibitor will have its greatest effect. All right, but in the limit of low substrate concentration, the Km term will dominate, and the inhibitor will have no effect when we get to a low enough substrate concentration. And so because of this, we can see that the inhibitor will have the smallest effect at lowest substrate concentration. Now, to turn to our question here, right, the question compares a PFR to a CSTR, and we expect the inhibitor will have a relatively greater effect on a PFR because in a PFR, you start at high substrate concentration at the beginning of the reactor, and the reaction proceeds down the length of the reactor to lower substrate concentration. Whereas in a CSTR, we operate at the final substrate concentration where the substrate concentration is lowest and where the inhibitor will have the least effect. And so we expect that the required space time will therefore go up by less than a factor of 2 for a CSTR, again, because it operates at the final or lowest substrate concentration everywhere inside the reactor.